हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम नैना डोगरा। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस एजिलाइट एग्जाम प्रेप चैनल। सो दिस एग्जाम प्रेप चैनल प्रेजेंटिंग यू प्रीवियस ईयर पेपर एनालिसिस ऑफ एचपी जोआ आईटी। सो दिस इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एग्जाम, सो वी हैव टू एनालाइज वन बाय वन ऑल द क्वेश्चंस। सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द आउटलाइन ऑफ सेकेंड फाइव ईयर प्लान बाज मेड वाई। इट मीन्स यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट द नेम ऑफ पर्सन हु गिवन द आउटलाइंस ऑफ सेकेंड फाइव ईयर प्लान। सो फर्स्ट वन इज बी एन गादगिल, सेकेंड ऑप्शन इज बी के आर वी राव, एंड द थर्ड ऑप्शन इज रिलेटेड टू पी सी महामेलनोविस, एंड वेर एज फोर्थ ऑप्शन इज सी एन बाकिल। सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन the name of person who given the outline of second five-year plan, the right option is the third option, which is P.C. Mahalanobis. So this is the right option. Move to our next question. So in this question, examiner tried to ask you who set up the base rate for banks. So first option is RBI, Reserve Bank of India, set up the base rate for banks. Second option is related to Ministry of our Finance. Third option is Ministry of our Commerce. And whereas fourth option is the individual banks board. So here examiner tried to ask you the base rate which was set by, basically the right option is related to individual bank rate. So individual banks board is the right option. This board is set up the base rate for banks. Move to our next question. In this question, the base policy in India is based on, first option is related to productivity, second option is related to standard of living, whereas third option is related to cost of living, and the fourth option is none of these. So you are left with three options, which is productivity, standard of living and cost of living. Here the base policy, which is related to cost of living. So third option is the basically a right option. Base policy is related to the cost of living. Move to our next question. So in this question, examiner tried to ask you the state. You need to find out the state has the literacy rate lower than the national average. Comparison with the national average and literacy rate. So first option is that particular state is Karnataka. Second option related to West Bengal. Third option is related to Andhra Pradesh. And the fourth one is Maharashtra. So in this context, the examiner tried to ask you the state where the literacy rate is lower than the national average. So right option is basically the Andhra Pradesh. Third option is the right option. This is a state where the literacy rate is lower as compared to the national average. So move to our next question. So in this question, again you need to find out the state in India. Which state in India is estimated to have the largest coal reserve in India? Largest coal reserve, majorly focus on coal reserve. So first option is coal reserve related to the our Bihar state. Second one is related to Jharkhand. Third one is Madhya Pradesh, and the fourth option is related to Odisha. So where we talk about the coal reserve in India, this largest coal reserve in India basically related to our Jharkhand state. So Jharkhand state in India, which is estimated to have the estimate that this state have the largest coal reserve in India. So move to our next question. In this question, the percentage of agriculture land is very high in all the following state except, this is very important, except means left that particular state. So the percentage of agriculture land is very high in all the following state. So first option related to Punjab, Haryana, second one, and third one is Uttar Pradesh, and fourth one is Sikkim. So no doubt here the examiner asked about except all these states, so right option is the Sikkim. where the agriculture land is not very much high, you can say. The percentage of agriculture land in Sikkim is low, you can say. So fourth one is the right option. Move to our next question. So in this question, which of the following is not, this is a golden word, not, which of the following is not a part of India's money market? You know the money market, basically it is a financial market. Financial market. As we know, financial market is basically related of two type, money market and second one is capital market. Money market is where the investment is only for 1 year, and more than 1 year there the market is capital market. So here examiner asked a very simple question, money market, which is not a part of money market. So first one option is bill markets, second one option is banks, third is related to our mutual funds, and the fourth one is Indian Gold Council. So no doubt fourth option is the right option, which is not a part of our money market, India's money market. So fourth option is the right option. So move to our next question. So if I talk about this question, in this question in India, the NABARD is basically a National Agriculture Board and Rural Development. So this bank basically focus on our agriculture as well as rural areas. So in India, the NABARD does not provide refinance to. So first option is related to our scheduled commercial banks. Second option is related to RRBs, which means regional rural banks. Third option is related to state land development bank. And the fourth option is related to export and import bank. So NABARD does not provide, here the examiner asks you the NABARD does not provide. So no doubt does not provide, the right option is the fourth option, export and import bank. NABARD does not provide refinance to export and import bank. And whereas scheduled commercial bank, regional rural banks and state land development banks, NABARD provide refinance to these type of banks except this export import bank. So move to our next question. In this question, examiner tried to ask you the latest item of expenditure in a current account of the central government budget, majorly focus on government budget, central government budget, the largest item of expenditure in the current account of central government budget. So first option is related to defense expenditure, second option is related to interest payments, third option is related to subsidies, and whereas fourth option is related to expenditure of social services. So largest item of expenditure, which is subsidies. So you can say third option is the right option. Largest item, subsidies of basically is the right option. Move to our next question. In this question, the Special Economic Zone Act, you need to find out the right year. The Special Economic Zone Act become effective in. So right option is the, you can say 2006. This is a wrong option, 2004, 2005 and 2007. A right option is the 2006 Special Economic Zone Act. Say for example, RBI Act is related to 1934. So this one is Special Economic Zone Act is related to 2006. So in this way you can learn all the terminologies. So let's discuss the physics section which are there in examination. So first question is the gravitational force are, first option is related to the biggest force in nature, second option is the strongest force, and whereas third option is related to negligible in nature, which means this is a wrong option. Negligible means nothing else. So negligible in nature, so this is a wrong option. So you are left with only two option. This is also a wrong option, none of these. So gravitational force is the biggest force in a nature. So you can say the first option is the right option. biggest force in nature. So move to our next question. In this question, examiner tried to ask you the thermal radiations. Radiation means rays of light. So thermal related to our heat. So thermal radiations are, first one is mechanical waves, second option is related to our magnetic waves, and the fourth one is electromagnetic, where the waves which combine electric field as well as magnetic field, electromagnetic waves. So thermal radiations are the electromagnetic waves. So third option is the right option. Move to our next question. In this question, a DC device, direct current, DC device which generates very high voltage is, first option is transformer, second option is related to rectifier, third option is related to DC generator, and the fourth one is induction coil. So a DC device which generates very high voltage, you need to find out the device name, DC device name. Most of the people say DC generator is the right option, but this is a wrong option. You neglect this option, DC generator. Rectifier is also a wrong option. Transformer is also a wrong option. So right option is the induction coil. This is a device which generates very high voltage. Here examiner tried to ask you very high voltage, majorly focus on very high voltage. So induction coil is the right option. Move to our next question. Which is the most elastic? The property is elastic. Most elastic. First option is related to vehicle, second option is glass, third option is rubber, and the fourth option is related to steel. So most elastic, there the elastic property, elasticity is very much high. So right option is the steel. Most of the people think about that rubber is the right option, but no, steel is the right option. Here examiner tried to ask you the most. So fourth option is the right option, which is steel. Move to our next question. So in this question, the pH means potential of hydrogen. pH of 7 signifies 7, where the pH value is equal to 7. But does it mean? First option is related to pure water, and second option is neutral solution, third is acidic basic. So these are the concept of less than and greater than. So these are wrong option. Firstly, you neglect these two option, pure water, and this is also a wrong option, pure water. So right option is the neutral solution, 7. pH value is equal to 7, it means it is related to neutral solution. So second option is the right option. So let's discuss our next question, which are there in examination of JOAIT previous year papers. So which one of the following compounds is insoluble in water? Here examiner asks you the name of compound which is insoluble in water. So first option is related to fructose, second option is cellulose, third option is related to maltose, and fourth one is related to cellobiose. So this is basically a wrong option. Firstly, you need to neglect this option. So you are left with three options. Fructose and maltose are not related to this compound, insoluble in water. So right option is the cellulose is the compound which is insoluble in water. So second option is the right option. Move to our next question. This is very easy question, you can say very easy question, which are there in examination. Penicillin was discovered by, the name of person who discovered penicillin. First option is Waksman, second option is Pasteur, third option related to Alexander Fleming. No doubt third option is the right option, which is Alexander Fleming, and the fourth option is the wrong option, Ronald Ross. This is out of the context, so you can say third option is the right option. Penicillin was discovered by Alexander Fleming. Move to our next question. So in this question, majorly focus on fats. Fats in human body are stored in which part of the human body? Basically, first option is related to liver, second option is related to pancreas, third option is kidney, and the fourth option is related to adipose tissue. So this is the wrong option, fourth option. Firstly, you need to neglect this option. Fat in human body, are stored in most important question, which is related to our kidney. Fat in human body are stored in kidney. So third option is the right option. So move to our next one. So in this question, examiner try to ask you the disease. So the disease which is thrombosis is associated with which part of our body? Heart. Second option is eyes. Third option is blood. And fourth option is related to lungs. This type of disease is basically related to our blood related disease, you can say. So third option is the right option. Move to our next question. This is very easy question. The citrus fruits are rich source of citrus fruits. First option is related to vitamin A. Second option related to potassium. Third option is iron, and the fourth option is related to vitamin C. So as you know, citrus fruits are very rich in vitamin A as well as vitamin C, but very rich source of. So fourth option is the right option, vitamin C. Most of the people confuse in these two options, vitamin A and vitamin C, but the right option is the vitamin C. So move to our next question. So in this question, the 2018 Vishwa Shanti Ashmisha. In this question, examiner tried to ask you 2018 BSAS. BSAS stand for Vishwa Shanti Ahimsa Sammelan. Has organized recently in which state? You need to find out the name of state. So first option is related to Maharashtra. Second one is related to Uttar Pradesh. And the third one is Gujarat. And whereas fourth option is related to Assam. So in this question, the right option is the Maharashtra. VSAS. This type of Sammelan, Ahimsa Sammelan, is related to the Maharashtra. Is a state which organized this type of Sammelan. So first option is the right option. So in this question, which of the following banks has recently become India's first PSU? PSU means public sector banks. So India's first PSU bank, public sector bank, to introduce the comprehensive wealth business schemes for its client. So apne clients ke liye best, you can say best comprehensive wealth business schemes. You need to find out the first, India's first public sector bank. First option is related to our SBI, State Bank of India. Second one is related to PNB, Punjab National Bank. And third option is Bank of Baroda. And the fourth option is related to Dena Bank. So in this question, the first private sector banks, PSU. So first option is the right option, which is related to our SBI, State Bank of India. Move to our next question. In this question, the famous Shahi Lichi. In this question, the famous Shahi Lichi. Which state has recently got the GI tag? GI means geographical indication tag. GI tag. So Shahi Lichi. So first option is related to Uttar Pradesh. Second one is Uttarakhand. Third option is Bihar. And fourth option is Manipur. So here examiner tried to ask you Shahi Lichi, famous Shahi Lichi. So no doubt fourth option is the right option, Bihar state. This is a state which got the GI tag for Shahi Lichi. So third option is the right option. In this question, which of the following states is set to become the India's first smoke-free state? India's first smoke-free state. So first option related to Karnataka. Second option is related to Kerala. Third option is Tamil Nadu. And the fourth option related to Andhra Pradesh. So in this question, examiner tried to ask you the India's first smoke-free state. So right option is related to Kerala. So second option is the right option. So BRB, the last question. Which state has recently celebrated the Kati Bihu Festival? Kati Bihu Festival 2018. This is a previous year question paper. So that particular current affairs is related to this type of question. First option related to Meghalaya. एंड सेकेंड ऑप्शन इज रिलेटेड टू आसाम एंड थर्ड ऑप्शन रिलेटेड टू वेस्ट बंगाल एंड फोर्थ वन इज झारखंड. कटी बिहू फेस्टिवल इज रिलेटेड टू राइट ऑप्शन इज द आसाम. सेकेंड ऑप्शन इज द राइट ऑप्शन. विद दिस आई एम गोइंग टू एंड द सेशन. वी आर बैक विद अवर वेरियस सेशंस विच आर मोर इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर यू. सो थैंक यू फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस.